Hey friends, it's Jessie. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be sharing my top fall 2021 palette picks. So these are the palettes that I've been pulling out a lot for fall, ones that I want to use a little bit more this fall. And I think for the most part, they're all current or newer palettes. I think there might be a couple that are on the older side, but I believe you can still purchase all of them. So I will link them all in the description box below in case you're interested in checking any of them out. But without further ado, let's get into some palettes. Can we just admire the fact that my earrings are little peach rings? They're so cute. I love them. These palettes are in no particular order. I just started pulling out all of my favorite fall palettes and then narrowed it down to my top 10 favorites out of all of them. So take it as you will. The first palette I want to talk about is the ColourPop It's a Mood palette. This is one of their larger, I think it's 30 or 35 pans. I can't remember the size of these. And normally I don't really care for big palettes like this. I've actually decluttered the majority of my Morphe palettes because I just don't reach for these big palettes. They stress me out trying to come up with color combinations, but there was something about this color story in this ColourPop palette that really spoke to me. You have all of your grungy tones, so you have like a side of neutrals, but you also have a side of more cool tones with the green and purple and blue story. This is the palette I'm wearing on my eyes today, and I really like all the combinations of looks you can come up with this palette. It reminds me a lot of the At Forest Site with Raw Beauty Christie palette too, so if you missed out on that one, this is such a good palette, and I can already tell this is going to be one of my favorites for holiday travel this year. Coming in at number two, we have the Natasha Denona Retro Palette. This one just came out. I picked it up from Sephora a couple weeks ago, but I love the tones in this. They're all muted, kind of neutral mauve shades. It's very, very perfect for just a soft, romantic fall look. I really like a lot of these like terracotta-y neutral shades, and some of these deeper like berry tones are just gorgeous. I think this is one of those that you wouldn't look at it and think fall, but when you think about it and actually use it, a lot of the looks I've created with this really remind me of fall leaves and just kind of cooler season, cooler weather. So I really wanted to include this palette in my top palette picks this year. Number three is the ColourPop Sonic Bloom palette. This one came out at Ulta and I believe is now available on the ColourPop website. But when you look at this, how can you not think of fall? You have the berries, you have the bronze, you have the green and the blue, and green and pink, like green and purple, are some of my favorite fall colors together because it's kind of that transition from green summer to more of like a rustic-y red fall. So I really like to include green and red shades together in my fall looks. And overall, I just think this is one of the most fall, screaming fall palettes in my collection. I think just even the packaging, the color story, everything about this palette, I look at it and I'm like, yep, it's fall. It's September, it's October, it's November, it's fall. I really wanted to include this palette in my fall palettes. I just am obsessed. I haven't gotten to use this one a ton this year. It's kind of hit the back burner with my Pan Those eyeshadows taking priority, but I do really, really like this color story and I did want to pull it out for my fall makeup basket. Number four goes to my Lethal Cosmetics and Teresa Is Dead collab, the Lethal Is Dead palette. A lot of the shades in this palette don't necessarily scream fall, like some of these brighter, deeper blues. I really like the color story overall, but the thing that really stood out to me as a fall characteristic is just the fact that this is all kind of horror or spooky themed. And literally anything with a spooky theme, I don't care what color it is. I am a sucker for Halloween. I got married on Halloween, so I love Halloween a lot. But all of these shades are very reminiscent of Halloween or horror themes. So you have names like Watery Grave and Vengeful Spirit and Spellbound. And what's more spooky than witches and murder? This is the only palette out of all of these that I'm not sure if it's actually still available or not. I know that they did a launch and then they sold out and then they did a pre-order and that's when I purchased mine. I pre-ordered it, so I didn't get it for a couple months after I ordered, but I really, really like the color story of this. And this was the first Lethal Cosmetics palette I tried and the Lethal formula is just superb. It's phenomenal. So pulled this one out, gotta have those spooky vibes for spooky season. Number five goes to my Too Faced Cinnamon Swirl palette. I like to collect these Too Faced holiday palettes. I think they're amazing. And it smells like cinnamon, which is great. The smell kind of smells like a Michael's craft store. It's a bit much, but the quality of this and the shades, I just felt like this was the perfect palette for a very soft, romantic fall look, kind of along the same lines of the Natasha Denona, but maybe a little bit more bronze or neutral than the Natasha Denona retro. I love the tones in here. It's just very, very soft. I could see this being a very good everyday wearable fall palette. So if you want to have some of those fall vibes, but don't want a super bright bronze or copper or red or orange look, I feel like this is the perfect palette for that. So you have all of your nice everyday deeper bronze shades, but then you also have a very good combination of very light, very muted tones as well to either blend things out or soften up a look a little bit. And I just think this is such a good staple fall palette. So if you are in the market for a new everyday palette, this is the good one. The next five could be taken either as fall palettes or maybe as winter palettes, kind of both. But these are ones that I see myself using for fall. So up next, number six is the Huda Beauty Wild Jaguar palette. I did do a video on this one, and honestly, at face value, it does not look like a fall palette, but I really like cool tones. And this is the only palette out of all of the palettes I pulled out that I would say is a cool tone palette. And I really, really liked this one. I loved the quality of this when I used it, and I loved the look I created in that video that I did. And it's just such a good palette. The formula is amazing. The color selection is amazing. So although it's not a fully fall color story, I wanted a good cool tone palette. I love a good cool tone palette. So I decided to choose this one to fill that void in my fall palette selection. The Huda Beauty Wild Jaguar, phenomenal, stunning, 10 out of 10. I would highly recommend this with the VIB sale coming up. Just a thought. Number seven should come at no surprise to anybody. I've mentioned this being the perfect fall palette several times in several videos. The Melt Rust palette. But how could you not think this is the perfect fall palette? You have that mustard yellow, you have those grungy neutrals, and you have a great range from light to dark. So you can create very high contrast looks with a very beautiful grungy neutral color story. When I think of fall palettes, this is what I think of. And when I thought of this video, this is one of the first palettes I thought of, but I wanted to make sure I included a lot of my newer palettes as well, things that are very relevant in the market still, but I could not include this palette. So absolutely great. I know I've done a video and a couple looks with this palette as well. It is still one of my favorites, if not my favorite melt palette. Just a great combination and absolutely stunning looks. Number eight goes to the Urban Decay Naked Wild West palette. This one I believe actually came out this past spring, which is kind of odd because you look at the color story and this does not look like a spring color story. This very much screams fall color story. So I really like that this one has a lot of those neutrals still. You have your lighter neutrals, you have a gold, you have a silver, which I thought was pretty interesting. I always like a good silver in conjunction with gold. I think they're a great combo. And then you also have pops of teal and aqua with this deep teal right here. This is just such a fun shade to use in the outer corner or as like a faux liner. But I really, really like the color story. In the past, I would have hands down put the Naked Heat in this grouping, but since this one has come out, I feel like this one is more fall themed than the Naked Heat. So this one beat out the Naked Heat for Urban Decay palette in my fall palette collection. Number nine, another oldie but goodie. This is the Natasha Denona bronze palette. I don't know if this one came out this year or last year, but regardless, I did purchase it this year, and need I say more? You have just about any bronzy orange neutral shimmer and matte shade you could want for a very easy everyday wearable all occasion palette. This has all the tones you need for an everyday look. You can do an all matte look, you can do an all shimmer look, you can do a smoky look, a sultry look, an everyday look, and you have this fun little like blue purple shade up at the top that you can use to really spice things up. This is one of my favorite deep shades in my entire eyeshadow collection. When I think of like faux liner, I always think of the shade, it's called Deep Dive. Great shade. And then this shade down here, Silk, such a stunning bronze shade. And Alloy, where is Alloy? Right in the middle here. Just a great golden bronze shimmer. So again, I could not mention this in a perfect fall palette video. Everything you could want. Absolutely love this palette. Super great. I almost didn't purchase this one, but I am so glad I did. And last but not least, we have my Pat McGrath Divine Rose 2 palette. Now I know what you're thinking. This does not seem like a fall palette, but it kind of does. Hear me out. You have the gold, you have the bronze, you have this great duochrome purple shade. And like I mentioned earlier, I love a good purple and green moment with fall eyeshadow, but you also just have some of the most perfect pinky purple shades. So this fills my pink and purple kind of void in my fall palette picks. You have the deep plum, you have this nice peach, and then like I said, you have the most beautiful shimmer shades. And this one, originally I would not have considered a fall palette myself, but I have found myself reaching for this one a ton, especially since the new the Hutopian palette came out. I've really pulled this one out because I went and saw the Hutopian in person and I was like, oh, it actually looks a lot like the Divine Rose 2. So I've been pulling this one out to kind of, I guess, persuade myself to not purchase the Hutopian palette. And I've discovered that this one really gives me fall vibes. Really enjoying this one for fall. And if you have this one, I would definitely recommend taking another look at it now that it is cooling down, for all of your fall palette needs. That is all for today's video, friends. If you did enjoy this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and let me know in the comments what palettes you're pulling out for fall this year. I hope you enjoyed the palettes I shared and I can't wait to hear your answers as well. Take care wherever you are and I will see you guys all in the next one. Bye, friends.